Welcome to Vision Academy. Today's current affairs English date 14th February 2019. Let us begin with national news updates. Bureau of Police Research and Development BPRD will organize the second conference of Micro Mission of National Police Mission in New Delhi. The two-day conference will discuss the issues of skills and competence at the grassroots level, aptitudinal changes in police, general sensitations, harness technology and community policing. The news says the second national conference of Micro Mission of National Police Mission will be organized by Bureau of Police Research and Development at New Delhi. This conference will be held for 2 days, and in this conference they will be discussing the issues of skill and competence at the grassroots level, aptitudinal changes in police, general sensitization, harness technology and community policing. Next news. The International Conference on Unani Medicine was held in New Delhi. It was organized by Central Council for Research in Unani Medicine under the Ministry of Ayush is organizing as a part of celebration of Unani Day, February 11. The theme of the conference was integration of Unani system of medicine in mainstream healthcare. News says the Central Council for Research in Unani Medicine have organized a conference called the International Conference on Unani Medicine. It will be held in New Delhi. And the Ministry of Ayush is organizing a celebration of Unani Day on February 11. Integration of Unani system of medicine in mainstream healthcare is the theme of this conference. Next news. Lavasya, in association with Bar Association of India, hosted its first Lavasya Human Rights Conference in New Delhi, with the motive to explore a broad range of human rights issues and relevance in Asia-Pacific region. The theme of the conference was State Power, Business and Human Rights, Contemporary Challenges. The news says Lavasya has hosted its first conference on human rights in New Delhi with the theme of State Power, Business and Human Rights in Contemporary Challenges. This conference is to have a broad range of human rights issues of relevance in Asian-Pacific region. This Lavasya is associated with Bar Association of India. Next news. The 5th International Dam Safety Conference 2019 will be held in Bhubaneswar. The two-day event, a joint initiative of the Government of India, the Government of Odisha and the World Bank, will conclude on February 14. The Dam Safety Conferences are being organized as an annual event in different DRIP states in collaboration with implementing agencies. News says the two-day conference on dam safety, which named as the 5th International Dam Safety Conference 2019, have planned to held in Bhubaneswar. This conference is a joint initiative of Government of India, Government of Odisha and the World Bank, will be concluded on February 14. It is a basic dam safety conference and it is being organized every year with the different DRIP states with the collaborating of implementing agencies. Next news. The center has decided to set up a national law university in Uttarakhand. This is a big step towards making Uttarakhand a quality education hub. India has 21 national law universities, admissions to which are held through a common law admission test. News says National Law University have decided to open a center in Uttarakhand. It is a big educational step towards Uttarakhand to make Uttarakhand one of the quality educational hub. The Common Law Admission Test is the only entrance of admission to all the 21 national law universities of India. Next news. Tamil Nadu Chief Minister K. Palaniswamy said a multiple disciplinary animal husbandry park will be set up in Salem district. The proposed park will have an advanced veterinary hospital, and a modern cattle, poultry, domestic dog, bull breeds, sheep, goat farms to explain the farmers about their scientific rearing. The news says K. Paranichami, who is the Chief Minister of our Tamil Nadu, have said that multidisciplinary animal husbandry park will be soon set up at Salem district. This park will have veterinary hospital and modern cattle, poultry, domestic dog, bull breeds, sheep and goat farms to explain to the farmers about their scientific rearing. Next, let us see international news updates. Ending a long-running dispute with Greece, the Republic of Macedonia has officially changed its name to North Macedonia. Greece had been blocking Macedonia's entry into Union European and North Atlantic Treaty Organization as it disapproved of the name of the country, as the Greek province of Macedonia had joining it as being associated with Alexander the Great. The news says Macedonia have changed its name to North Macedonia to end the long-running dispute with Greece. Greece have been blocking Macedonia's entry with European Union and North Atlantic Treaty Organization. Since the meaning of Macedonia is associated with Alexander the Great. Next, let us see economy updates. National Film Development Corporation of India was announced as a winner under the Mini Ratna category by Ministry of Macro, Small and Medium Enterprises in its campaign to felicitate the CPSCs in recognition of their work in promoting SCST entrepreneurs. News says Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises have chosen National Film Development Corporation of India as a winner of Mini Ratna category. Winning is under the campaign to facilitate CPSCs to recognize their work in SCST entrepreneurs. Next, let us see awards. Siddhartha Lal, MD and CEO of Eicher Motors, has won the EY Entrepreneur of the Year 2018 after transforming Eicher Motors and helping the company usher in the Royal Enfield motorcycle brand in India and making it a global brand icon. News says Siddhartha Lal, who is the MD and CEO of Eicher Motors, has won the EY Entrepreneur of the Year 2018 award. This happened after he transformed Eicher Motors and helping the company restaurant of Royal Enfield motorcycle in India and also by making it an global brand icon. Science and Tech Updates. Minister of State for Ayush, Shripad Yosho Nayak, launched the e-Ayushradi portal for online licensing for Ayurveda, Siddha, Yunani and Homeopathy drugs and related matters. The portal's objective is increasing the transparency, accountability and improving information management facilities and data usability. The new e-portal is acronym for Ayurveda, Yunani, Siddha and Homeopathy automated drug helping initiatives. News says Shripad Yosho Nayak, who is a Minister of State IC for Ayush, have recently portal a license on e-Ayushadi, which is a license for Ayurveda, Siddha, Yunani and Homeopathy drugs. And this is a new e-portal for Ayurveda, Yunani, Siddha and Homeopathy with automated drug helping initiatives. Next, let us see books and authors. Former Vice President Amit Hansari on 8th February 2019 launched the new book of former Finance Minister P. Chidambaram named Undaunted, Saving the Idea of India at Nehru Memorial Museum in New Delhi. The book is a collection of essays on the country's atmosphere of fear and how the constitutional values are being threatened. The news says the former President Hamid Hansari have launched the new book of former Finance Minister P. Chidambaram, which named Undaunted, Saving the Idea of India at Nehru Memorial Museum, New Delhi. The book will have a collection of essays with country's atmosphere of fear and how constitutional values are being threatened.
To have a daily current affairs updates, subscribe to Vision Academy and don't forget to press the bell button below. And if you think the video is informative, like this video, share this video, comment below for the doubts.